Hi and welcome to another episode of Find Zen with VR, hosted by Virtuous Retail and Zen Finder. I'm your host, Ranjit Babbar, and co-founder of Zen Finder. Today we're discussing a huge challenge of the new reality, which is parenting. And how do you keep your kids engaged during this period of lockdown? To help us in today's conversation, we're talking to Lacha Sanghvi, who is a developmental psychologist and the founder of Firefly Counseling Center. Welcome to the show, Lacha, and thank you for taking the time out to be with us today. So we've been in conversation with a lot of parents, Lacha, and quite a few of them are simply asking, how do we keep kids engaged? Kids are unable to fully understand the seriousness of the current issue, and because of that, might have a lot of questions. And because of the lockdown, the kids are unable to expend their physical energy. So what would you recommend parents do at this time?
So Ranjit, I'm going to basically answer this question of how to expend our children's energy in two ways, okay? The first is going to kind of speak about the psychological energy that's built up, and second is going to be all that physical energy that's built up in our kids because they're indoors all the time. So what's happening psychologically for our kids? What we need to understand is that we're going through a crisis. And a crisis, by definition, is a period of great difficulty and vulnerability. So it's natural that we're going to be going through, and our children are going to be going through, some very primary emotions as their very survival and safety is threatened. So one of the most natural emotions that is going to come up at this time is fear and anxiety, feelings of helplessness and out of control, because we really truly are out of control right now and we're helpless. We can't change things outside our home right now. So how do we help kids through this? First, we need to understand that children are literally going through two or threefold more amounts of anxiety than we as adults are going through. The reason for this is that developmentally, the prefrontal cortex is not developed. Now, the prefrontal cortex is that part of the brain which is responsible for intellectual functioning, like reasoning, thinking, logic. So children truly, they're not developed in the sense of intellect the way we adults do. They truly can't comprehend and they don't understand. They can't understand what this pandemic means, what the implications are. It's developmentally not possible for them. Now that coupled with all the tidbits of information that they're going on overhearing through our adult conversations, the WhatsApp messages, the news, the dinner table conversations, and when they add their own meaning to it, there's a complete chaos and jumble in their mind. Secondly, most of them, depending on their age, haven't developed the communication and language skills to express these emotions and to work through them. So it's of paramount importance for us as caregivers and parents to understand the psychological state. So how do we help children through all this anxiety that's probably been building up within them? First and foremost, what I would like to urge or guide to parents is to accept, expect, and allow for the big emotions. Understand that there are going to be some big emotions that might be coming up right now in our children. And the way that each child kind of expresses it is going to be different, all right? Some child may become very defiant. Another child might just withdraw. Another child might be waking up with nightmares or become very clingy. Please understand that it is because of all the psychological energy that's built up. So how do we help them through it? Once we allow and understand these feelings, it's important for us as caregivers to be empathetic, to not judge these feelings, and most importantly, to be a safe space where they can talk about these feelings, they can discuss these feelings, and they can work through them without being judgmental. Now is the time to be compassionate, tolerant, and patient with your children. Secondly, what's really important is that, okay, just I'd like to use an example here. Just imagine that you're in an aircraft and it's going through massive turbulence. And then you suddenly hear the voice of your pilot. And he's telling you to put on your seatbelt. He's giving you all the necessary instructions, what you need to know to get through the turbulence. We feel relieved. We feel relaxed. We know that we're taken care of, that the pilot knows what he's doing. How would you feel if the pilot was panicking and giving you instructions out of a place of fear and anxiety? Scared, right? So remember that you are the pilot of the aircraft of your home in this period of turbulence. So make sure that you're calm, you're centered, you're grounded as you're going through your daily routines. Thirdly, talk. Talk to the children about COVID. Of course, you don't need to give them too much information because that's not healthy either. But not talking about it, suppressing it, also is not going to help either. When children get age-appropriate facts from a safe source, they feel safe and they feel in control. So answer their questions, set time aside. Obviously, don't overdo it. Thirdly, remember that in this time of helplessness, children are seeking control. So what we could do is we can kind of add on some avenues where they feel like they're in charge. So let them make choices about their routine. Talk to them about what kind of food they'd like to eat today. Simple stuff. For the younger kids, you can let them choose the clothes they want to wear. Basically, let them have some choice, some control in their day-to-day life. All right? And also, what I like to do with like a lot of my older kids is you can actually take a pen and paper and you can make them write down, like, you know, draw two circles. The inner circle are things which are in their control. Let them list it out. And the outer circle that you draw, write down things which are not in their control. And just a small, simple exercise helps the children feel more relaxed. So Renji, this is about the question of psychological energy. Now I'm going to come to the second part of my thing, all that physical energy that's spent up. How do we kind of help them while they're not able to go outdoors? So first and foremost, routine is very, very important. So sit with your kids, okay? Because it's like overnight, their home and school routine has been taken away, all right? So what you need to do is you need to sit with the children, let them have control in that process too. So plan it with them, make it like a fun exercise and let your routine be consistent. Okay, kind of let it have a balance of both structured activities and even time for free play. And when you're adhering to the routine, balance is the key. So you don't want to be too rigid about implementing it. And at the same time, you want to make sure that it is not totally going out of the window and that you're kind of managing to follow that timetable that you've together set. Another very important thing is make way for some kind of physical exercise during the day. You can play tons of games with them. There's lots of stuff available on YouTube. You can think of creative and innovative ways to set up obstacle courses at home, do simple jumping jacks, use the skipping rope, all of that. Thirdly, let them get creative. Things like craft exercises, getting them involved in baking, making new projects, science experiments, all of that helps all that energy that's building up to find some kind of outlet. Fourthly, involve them in household chores and routines. Things like folding clothes, setting the table, doing the dishes, make it fun. The key is to have a lot of fun. Don't make it a task, make it like a fun family thing that you're all doing together. Fifth, what you can do is read tons of books, play board games, and you can also schedule Zoom sessions with their kids. That helps meet their needs for social communication and meeting their friends. So that I think should, a lot of all of this should help in meeting their physical and emotional needs.